Hello, everybody. Welcome to MC Amakhosi Fan Channel. This is something to like, comment, subscribe. So yeah, guys, I'm doing a match reaction against Cape Town City. For me, I don't know about you, but yeah, what a boring draw. It was a boring, dull draw. You know, we could see that we are an away team. Even if we are a big team and we are against a team that has been losing left and right, that haven't been doing well. Like, yeah, we are still doing find a fun. It's like we are trying to build, but there's nothing, you know. We've been building and building and building, but I don't see what we are building. Like, I've been saying to you, and it's not that I hate CJ, but this was me from the get-go, and now I've been like, nah, I think I can't wait for the end of the season. And by the way, it's only 9 games that is left to the season to finish, and I'm like, I can't wait. It's like we can fast forward those games because, like, wow, what we're watching, nah, like I can't swallow it. Like, I can't swallow it. We are playing like ugly football. Like, we're playing ugly football with no direction, no sense of agency. Can't string amongst ourselves, like few passes amongst ourselves. I don't mean those passes that we play backwards and then we say that no, it was like we stringed amongst ourselves like 5, 10 passes. No, I don't mean that. I don't understand a style of play under Coach Johnson. I mean, this was his 13th game, and still in 13th game you haven't figured your starting 11. And as much as you haven't figured your starting 11, but you still haven't like established a style of play. And also there are other players that will play well this time, and then next game they are out there, they are on the stands and are not nowhere to be found, and there's no communication, there's no clear communication. Where are the players and why other players are starting on the bench when they played well in the previous game? Like, there are guys that I don't know whether they're not paying CJ money for them to start, because it seems as if other players are paying CJ like money to play. Like, I'm not accusing him, but it looks like other players are being preferred above others. Like, let's tell the truth here. Let's tell the truth. We know the players, and I can't keep on coming back and telling you that so and so and so and so this coach doesn't like. But I'm gonna speak about the coaches, the players who play well this game, the following game, they are nowhere to be found. Either they are on the bench, if not on the bench, they are like nowhere to be found. They are on the stands, if not on the stands, they're not even in that 18-man squad. And I'm asking myself, like, on the real, what are they supposed to do to be picked? What are they supposed to be to do for them to be looked at and say that I see your efforts and I appreciate your efforts, and therefore I'm gonna reward you? I see so many of you are marveled, like you are raving about Sithibe, him playing well and whatnot. For me, I do not think that Sithibe will play in the next game. I've been proven time and time again that the coach doesn't like certain players. Like, his hand was twisted. His hand was forced for him to make that decision to play Sithibe yesterday. Yes, many of us, including I had expected to see Zwane. I had expected to see Zwane, but Sithibe, yeah, he rose to the occasion. But will he be there next game? Will Zwane play next game? Chances are very, very slim. There might be like 1% of chances of him playing, because we know that the coach will play Castillo. If not play Castillo, will play Matt. If not play Matt, will play them both, and then we'll leave out him Ted. So next game we're gonna play on Tuesday. As that game we're gonna play on Tuesday, I can tell you this for free. I'm gonna tell you this for free. We don't have a certain starting 11, except that there are few individuals in the starting 11 who'll always play ahead of others. It's like it's been settled that so and so will play. Regardless of how they perform, so and so they'll play when they come back from suspension or when they come back from injuries. Sorry. Guys, let me go back. I've been saying this, that Nobo, it seems like it doesn't matter how many times he performs, he's gonna start on the bench. Nobo proved that, you know what, he's a solid center back, and he played very well. And most of you who were undermining him and who were looking down on him, because I've been saying this, that we must take care of Ngcobo. Ngcobo needs to play more games. Most of you. But you won't come back and say it to me and say that no, we made a mistake. But most of you, when we considered those goals that you considered when Kunika was pairing with Msimang, you're like, but why Ngcobo is not playing? But I've been saying to you that Ngcobo seems to be the player that would give us like solid performance. Will give us solid performance. Will perform. Will give his all, and he's gonna do well. But come this game, when so and so is back, he's gonna start on the bench. This coach also seems to. I'll come back to this. This coach seems to not to know who which player plays on which position. Yeah, this coach does not know which player plays on his position. For example, two players I'm gonna speak about, if not three. Let me say two for now. We'll get to three if time permits. Dupriz, I was asking myself, Dupriz, where is he gonna play? Is he gonna play as a winger? Or is he gonna play as what? Against Pirates, Juba was on the bench when he played very well against Golden Arrows. When he even scored the winning goal against Golden Arrows, the following game against Pirates, he sat on the bench. And Dupriz was a striker. Ashley was a striker on the day. Now, Dubai is back on the starting lineup. Why did not he play against Pirates? Why did not he start against Pirates? But he's starting again. Where is his consistency there? So he comes in, he plays as a striker. He's showing his hunger. He's missing those chances. Sure. Like the first chance that he got, the ball comes to his left instead of trapping with his left. Or trapping and shooting with his left, he wants to turn. The ball is going that direction, like follow the ball where it's going, and then you want to hit it with an open foot. Already, the ball is coming to the wrong side of you, and then still you still want to use your side, your strongest foot. And even so, the technique is not right because you're using an open foot and the ball is in the air. Why are you not hitting it? Like straight with the front of your foot. Why are you not like hitting it down, either down and then it goes up or straight? Like there's a net that is before you. I don't know how many chances that you created yesterday that the keeper saved. I think there was one or two in the entire game, one or two where the keeper like was demanded to make a save. We did not create so many chances yesterday. Sharp. Back to the players. Duba comes in, he plays as a striker. Dupriz goes to the wing. They sub Duba, and then Ranga is warming up. And then he takes this guy. He takes, instead of putting in a striker for a strike, already we are chasing the game. Like the minutes are going down, like the minutes, like they are slipping away from us. We're gonna get a draw. You're making substitutions that sometimes I don't understand. Either they are late, or sometimes I'm like, what is the coach trying to achieve here? You substitute a striker, you put it on a winger because now you're taking Dupriz and putting him as a striker. Where does Dupriz play when he played as a striker against Paris and scored a brace? Second game is going to start as a wing. So many of us will be sitting down here complaining like, but this player is not scoring goals. But when we judge him fairly, is he playing as a striker? Are all the games that he plays as a striker? I always said that he's not a striker, he's a either you can use him sure as a false nine, but he's an inverted winger. A winger would come in and who'll score those goals. But we still want to insist we play him as a striker today. Next week we play him as a winger. Like it's also causing confusion when they practice and prepare for the upcoming game. Is he preparing as a winger or is he preparing as a striker? Like, how does it work? Like, how does it work? Duba is not treated fairly. Ranga is not treated fairly and apparently Ranga wants to leave because he's not getting game time under this coach. So he wants to leave. Dupriz is also not treated fairly. You said, but he's playing all the games, but where is he playing? Is he playing as a striker or is he playing as a wing? Nobo is not treated fairly. He's gonna start on the bench. If Msimang was to get injured, or whichever center back was to get injured, He's going to start there. And so many of you are raving about Sithembe yesterday playing very well. And I said this when Matt got a man of the match. I think it was against Arrows. And I said to you, the reason why these players are playing the way that they're playing, because there's someone who's easing the pressure away from them who says that I will hold the fort here and then you go forward, you can attack as much as possible. Look how Sithembe played yesterday. A perfect example of a box-to-box midfielder. Someone was found at the back collecting the ball, and someone was found there. He had three shots yesterday. Three shots. And also his technique and him not anticipating some of the balls, he could have scored. Like he could have scored. There were chances that he was by himself at the far post. Two of them, he was by himself at the far post. And also him playing closely to the striker as that box-to-box, it does not mean that he's a 10. Give him that role to play as a box to box, the freedom to go up front and freedom to come back and defend, but he's not a number 10. How many chances did he chip in for Duba? Chances did he chip in for Dupriez? So many chances that he chipped in for these guys, but they could not get to the ball and use those opportunities. He played very well, but I am afraid he's not going to start the next game. He's not going to start the next game. Coach's favorite, Matt, is going to be back. Sithembe is going to sit on the bench. The Mteto is going to sit on the bench. And Castillo will play. When will we see a fresh combination? Because these combinations, like at the in the middle of the park, they're not working for us. Castillo has lost form. Matt is on and off. And he's not subbed when he's off the game, and then he's gonna come in and he play 90 minutes and come next game, he's gonna start ahead of players who are hungry and they've been showing that they're hungry, and whenever they get a chance, they perform. But the coach will not see that. But us fans will be fighting amongst ourselves, will be seeing that and we'll be like, but why are these players played in out of positions and whatnot? Mteto will not play because the coach does not see him, but yet he does not see the combination, or he sees the combination is not working, but he's insisting on playing Castillo and Math. So next game, players who've been mistreated and are playing out of position. Dupriez at Dubai has been used as a tip back. He was subbed because he was injured. Solomons comes in. Solomons, is he playing as a right winger or is he playing as a right back? Guys, we seem to be like, we are lacking direction. I'm sorry, we are lacking direction and I don't know where we're going with this coach. The sooner this league finishes, the better for us because we are lacking direction. Players are played out of position, and when they play very well, like look at Solomon's yesterday, come in, takes on players, cross. Sure, probably he delayed that pass, that cross. He should have passed it because there was an oncoming player, but then he pushed it ahead an extra 2 touches or so, and then he played it, and then it was then deflected out for a corner kick. But other than that, he had a good game. Like you'd find him going forward, find him going back. That's one thing that I love about him. I would not fault Kunika yesterday. Kunika had a good game. One of the players who had a good game. But if we're watching him based on like we don't like this player, we won't see that he was one of the best players yesterday at the back. We might differ, but he had one of those good games. But I still don't prefer him. But now, should it be a matter of preference or should it be a matter of you performed and then you are rewarded? Because I can't say this to this about this player and say the other one about the other player. Let's be fair. Kunika played well yesterday as a right back. Also, he's not playing his position. Sometimes a center back, sometimes a right back. So that's why I'm like, the coach is really confused. Never mind about players who can play multi positions, but at the same time, we need to build a team going forward and people to master, if that's the word, master their position and do well in that position, and then they keep on improving their position. But today they're at the center. Today they're at the wing. It's easy to play on the wing. It's easy to play on the wing. You also should make sure that you cover one position, which is on the left side, on your left, if you're playing as a right back. Because here on the right, you push the player out and you make sure that he does not pass. He does not go past you. If you're playing the center back, you need to look both positions. Like that's why when I play six, sometimes it's one of the hardest positions because I need to check what is happening behind me, before me, like on the sides and whatever. But if you're playing a wing, you're also sure about what is happening inside. And if a player, you always push him on the line. Push him on the line. If you're playing as a wing, make sure that you push him on the line. You don't show him the inside. Show him the line, push the ball outside or push the player out. And always play the ball simple. It's easy outside to play it safe when you're playing on the wing or as a right back or as a left back. Play it simple. You win the ball. If you see there are no options, play it safe. Let's come back and mark. But if you're playing as a center back or if you're playing as a central defensive midfield or that midfield, you can switch the ball out and say, no, let us come back in the group and then we'll get the ball and then we'll build from there. So I don't know how they're preparing if today you're playing as a center back, tomorrow you're playing as a right back. Hlanti needs competition. He had an okay-ish game, but yeah, going forward, could have given us more. Could have given us more. The two center backs, Dove had a good game. Simango really had a good game. But also, this is another thing that is confusing Simango because today he's playing with Dove, tomorrow is playing with Quinic. Like tomorrow when Ditlokwe is back, as he's gonna be is coming out of injury. Is recovering tomorrow. It's the clock. Like it's confusing, guys. You can blame all these players what you like, but forming combinations is one of the major things and paramount things when it comes to winning games. We are lacking combinations. Players are playing out of position, and players are not given a fair chance when they perform very well. Who's gonna be a striker in this game? Why Saile came on later on? Why Dranga came late in the game? Dushabalala, he needs to not to be a 45 minutes player or a 10 minutes or 20 minutes player because first half he was out, second half the first 10 or so minutes was our lively player. Like he was our lively player, the way he would switch the play, taking on chances, taking on players was our lively player. But first half, yeah, he was dipping in and out of the game. Modi, I think he needs competition as well because his form has dipped. I thought that it was coming back. It has dipped. Duba, yeah, you can see that he's still growing. I would not be hard on him. Vuma did not really have so many chances to save or balls to save, except that ball that hit the woodwork. Two center backs, they played okay. Yes, good yesterday. The Kwenika played very well for me. Played very well for me. And then the left, yeah, Santi had, yeah, was off going forward. And even this guy. He was off going forward, but he had a good game. Sithibe and Matt, their combination, I really enjoyed it. But first few minutes, they were off, and then they started clicking, getting each other, understanding each other. They played that position very well, the central defensive midfield very well. Yes, it was Sithibe mainly who was standing there kicking players, which that's what you want when you play a CDM. Matt had a good game, very good game, but unfortunately, I feel sorry for him. He might not play the second game against this game that we're playing Tuesday. I'll still check, but yeah, Tuesday. Then, like I said, Modi, I said with Dupriz. Yeah, he's confused. And he's confused not because he's a confused player, but because the coach confuses him. Today, he's playing as a striker, he's a winger, and sometimes he plays as a winger. Sometimes, like, that's confusing. Duba, he has to learn and needs to grow and have composure and share the ball. I like his pressing. I love how the team is pressing and winning the ball up front. But what do you do when you have the ball? Who was your man of the match for me? It was Sithibe. I hope and I pray and I wish that he can play the game that you're playing on Tuesday. But chances are slim for me. I would tell you. Let me just do it now. Let me just do it now. Yeah, the post-match. I mean the preview, match preview, the match preview. Cause yeah, let me just sum up everything just in this episode, and then I'll post after that game on Tuesday. I'll see. But yeah, I'm not gonna do a match preview. Keep Vuma. Quinica played very well. Let us reward him. played well, let us reward him. The two centre backs, they played well, let us reward them. Hlanti still needs a competition. But in the meantime, Mashiyane, we know that he played well and then came back and did not play the following game. Like, yeah, Hlanti. And then keep, no matter what you do, keep Mteto. He's gonna grow into this game, he's gonna grow into this team. He needs time. Grow him. Give him time so he grows. Sithebe, reward him as well. Like, let these guys sit on the bench. Dushaul is not a player that the coach like I don't understand. Don't understand. I mean, Dantzan, I don't understand why he did not play that game against Pirates. Like, but yeah, I mean, he played against Pirates, but he did not start a game. Like, why, coach? So number 10, Shabalala did not convince me yesterday. Bring back Mdanzane. Bring back Mdanzane. And then on the right. On the right. Love Saile, you know this. Sure, keep Dupriz on the left. Oh, do this. Put Dupriz on the left. Put Dupriz on the left. Put Saile on the right. Inverted wingers. And then strike with Ranga. Give Ranga a chance. Give Ranga a chance. I'm assuming, can't even predict, but yeah, that'll be my starting lineup. That game we are playing, let me see who are we playing against. Hey guys, I'm sorry, we are playing against, who are we playing against on Tuesday? Kaizer Chiefs next game. We're playing against Stellenbosch. Oh, it's not Tuesday, it's Saturday. Eh? Yes, Tuesday, sorry. Playing against Stellenbosch on Tuesday. Stellenbosch, they won yesterday. Let me check how much, what was the score? They won 3-0 against Raleigh M. They won 3-0. They come into this game with their heads up, tails up. They have confidence, and we are going to this game like we have been dropping points. In available 9 points, we collected 4 points, gave away five. A team that is high flying as Stellenbosch. Somehow we beat Stellenbosch, but I've lost hope on CJ. Like, I even lost hope on CJ. I really lost hope on CJ. There's something about CJ that I don't understand. I don't understand CJ. So yeah, sorry guys about this. Like, I just want to check how many more matches. Like, I mean, we're losing an opportunity to go up front, go above Pirates. We are 2 points behind Pirates. We are dropping points. They lost Pirates. I'm like, but when are we gonna go up there? So the last game we played against them, we won 2-0. Game prior that we won 2-1. Game prior that we won 3-0. This is a team that we built, we beat. Game prior that we won 3-1 rather, and then we won 4-1. Game prior that we lost 1-0. Not bad, not bad, not bad at all. Really not bad at all, but we're going to this game. I don't have confidence on the coach. I don't have confidence on the chance. I don't see the direction of our team. I don't see. But yeah, let me just say that they're gonna draw that game. They're gonna draw. Draw, nil nil, draw 1-1, but we're gonna draw this game. Gonna draw. But yeah, guys, I'm out. FC Amakhosi fan channel. I love you guys. Take care. Bye.